Hi friends, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudoku and Puzzles. Ashish here, and today I'll be covering a Sudoku variant called Mini Golf Sudoku. Now the name, it was named by the authors. Actually the Sudoku is constructed by two authors, Nityant Agarwal and Iliaskar, and it was named as Mini Golf Sudoku, but the hybrid, it's a hybrid variation, and the variants used here are thermo and quadruples. So the thermo bulbs are not given, but I will let you know about the rules of this Sudoku. I was given this Sudoku suggested by a friend that it's a really good Sudoku and I should solve it. So I solved at my leisure, and after solving I realized that it's really an excellent construction. So I thank Nityant Agarwal and Iliaskar for such a wonderful Sudoku and giving me an opportunity to cover a video on our channel. And after a long time I'm covering a Sudoku variant, so it will be a really different for me too. And now coming on to the Sudoku, so the Sudoku is named as Mini Golf Sudoku, and there are two variations used in it, right? One is the Thermo Sudoku and one is the Quadruple Sudoku. So what are the rules of the Quadruple Sudoku? So classic rules apply. We have to have digits in each row, 1 to 9 each column, and 3 to 3 box without repetition. So as you can see, there are some circles which has some numbers inside it. So those numbers indicate the numbers have to be in these four cells, or in one of these four cells, right? So for example, if you have a 4 year, so four has to be in one of these four cells. You have a 4 year as well, you have a 5 year, you have 2 5 5 year, which means that there has to be 2 5 year and 1 2 year and one any other digit. So if there are not all four digits given, other three digits can be anything. As you can see here, there are all the four digits given here, 1 2 7 8, which means all 1 2 7 8 would have to be in these four cells in any order. We are not sure about the order, they can be in any order, jumbled. You can have 1 2 here, 7 8 here, or 1 2 7 8, anything, but the numbers have to be placed in these four cells. And apart from that, you have some thermo lines here, but without the bulbs. So what is a thermo sudoku? In thermo sudoku, you have one end of the line has a bulb and the other end has a just flat end, and which means that the numbers will have to be increasing from the bulb to the flat end. But here the bulb is not given, so bulb would have to be in any one of these two ends, right? And it's upon the solver to find where the bulb would be, right? So you can have a bulb here and the numbers would have to be increasing in this order, or you can have a bulb here as well and the numbers would have to be in this increasing order, right? So these are the rules. And with that, we'll start solving this Sudoku. So I would really appreciate if you could subscribe to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles if you haven't done so. It will really motivate us to cover videos on daily basis. And if at all you have a request for any Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, do let us know in the comment below and we'll surely make a video on it, right? And now coming on to this Sudoku again. So I have already solved this Sudoku, so I know the solve path of it. But I would really recommend you to try this Sudoku first yourself, because it's an excellent construction. And do check out the video for the solve path. So I'm not sure if that was the intended solve path that I would be showing you, but I really enjoyed the solve path. And please do watch the video for whole video for the excellent solve path here. And now we'll start solving this Sudoku. So the first thing that I noticed in these Sudokus or these kind of placement of thermo cells are, so whenever you have these kind of placement of thermo cells, the first thing I did was, whatever digits you have here cannot be in any of these three cells, right? Because the numbers would have to be either in the increasing order or the decreasing order from any end. So for example, if you have the increasing order from this end, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, so you have 2 3 4 here and 5 6 7 here, right? So let me show you. If you have that in the increasing order, so whatever digits, these three digits you have cannot be in these three cells. None of the, even a single digit from these three cells cannot be on these lines, because it is a thermo sudoku, right? A thermo line. So a thermo line can never have two same digits on the line. It is never ever possible, because it will have to be strictly increasing. That is what the rule says. It has to be strictly increasing. So which means that if you have a 1 year, this cell would have to be greater than 1. So it cannot be again 1 and 1 then 2. So that is what the rule strictly increasing means. And with that, I noticed that these three cells and these three cells will always be different. which means that whatever digits you have in these three cells cannot be in these three cells, of course, cannot be in these three cells as well, which means whatever digits you have in these three cells will have to be in these three cells, and those again three digits using the classic rules will have to be in these three cells. So that gave us one of the excellent markings here, right? So you cannot have these three digits in any of these six cells, you have to have in these three cells, right? Same way, whatever digits you have in these three cells cannot be in these three cells, of course, cannot be here as well, will have to be here, and using the classic rules will have to be here. That was the first thing that I looked for while solving this Sudoku, and this is the most important thing that you do, right? Highlight the cells here, or coloring technique. I would, in other words, it is nothing but a coloring technique. So whatever you have here will have to be here, will have to be here. So all the red cells will have same digits, all the green and all the yellow. Okay? And why I enjoyed this Sudoku very much, because the constraint here are very, very less. As you can see, there are only 4 thermo lines, but we haven't discovered the bulbs yet. And very few quadruples here, very few quadruple clue. As you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And out of the 5, 3 are just 1 digit quadruple clue, right? That's an excellent construction, I would say. And with that, the continuation of the Sudoku would be okay. So I remember that you need to have 5 in these 4 cells, 2 times, right? Okay, so I'll just erase the highlighter here. Okay, so as you can see here, you need to have 5 in these 4 cells. So you can have one of the 5 will have to be in one of these 2 cells and on these 2 cells, or in these 2 cells and these 2 cells. So whatever you do, you'll have 5 in these 2 cells or in these 2 cells. And whatever be the case, you cannot have a 5 in this line at all, thermo line. So this thermo line is of 7 cells, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Which means that out of 9 cells or out of 9 digits, you need to have 7 digits, distinct digits placed in this thermo line. Out of which 5 is not possible in any of these lines. 5 is not possible in these 2, not possible in these 2, not possible in these 2, only possible here. But that is of course not possible, because 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 or 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You'll just end up here. You cannot have anything here. So 5 cannot be in any of these cells at all. So which means that out of the 9 digits here, 5 is eliminated and you only have 8 digits remaining. Out of the 8 digits, the middle cell can only be 4 and 6. Right? It cannot be a 5. Of course, it cannot be a 5. It cannot be 7 as well. Because if you have a 7 here, in either one of the direction, you'll have 8 and 9 and one cell will be remaining. Right? Of course. So, let us see if we had anything else here. Okay. So, the same thing applies here in this thermo line as well. What thing applies here is, you cannot have a 5, okay, so in the middle cell, instead of 4 and 6, you can have here 4, 5 and 6, right? That is a possibility. But I can directly say that you cannot have a 5 here. Why? Because that is why the highlight of the colors was very, very useful. As you know that in box 3, 5 would have to be in one of these 4 cells, either in the green cells or the red cells, which means that the yellow cells can never have a 5. And whatever you have in these yellow cells will have to be in this cell. So this cell cannot be a 5 now. So this will have to be 4 or 6. Right? That's an excellent, excellent start here. And with that we'll continue this. Excellent. So you get a 4-6 pair here. Right? Will that be helpful here? Let us see. Okay. You cannot have a 4-6, okay. Okay, so with that we'll continue this Sudoku. The other thing that I noticed in this Sudoku was the 5s here. 5 pointing towards the box 8 cannot have 5 in these 3 cells, so 5 would have to be in these 2 cells. You'll have 1, 2, 7, 8 here. And one of the 4, 6, whatever you have here, either 4 or 6 will have to be in these 2 cells. So you have, one of the 5s will have to be here. and other digit will have to be either 4 or 6 in any of these two cells because of the 4 6 here, right? And that gives us one of the excellent logics here. 5 cannot be in this cell now. So in this thermo line, I again deduce because of this 5 that 5 cannot be anywhere in this thermo cell. Of course, 5 cannot be in the first two cells or the last two cells. Of course, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You'll have one last line remaining. So 5 cannot be in the first two cells or the last two cells. 5 cannot be in these two cells as well because it cannot be in the yellow cell. And the only cell remaining now is the third cell from the bottom, which cannot have a 5 because of the pointing 5 in box 8. Right? So this line also cannot have a 5. Now, which means that this line will also have numbers except 5 from 1 to 9, which means one more number is yet to be eliminated, and then we can directly place the pencil marks of the digits here. So that's a really excellent logic here, and that logic gives us that red cells cannot have the 5. Of course, 5 cannot be in the first two cells of the thermo line. It cannot be here because of the 5 here, which means 5 cannot be in the red cells, 5 cannot be in the yellow cells. So 5 would have to be in one of the green cells, right? Green cells would have a 5 here, and 5 cannot be here because of the pointing 5 here, and 5 cannot be here because of the pointing 5 here, right? And with that, we'll continue this Sudoku. Okay, so one of the other things that will help you is you'll have to look out for the digits in these three cells. You cannot have 1, 2, 7, 8. You cannot have 5. So the remaining 4 digits are 3, 4, 6 and 9. Right? 1, 2, 7, 8 are not possible. 5 is not possible. So you have 3, 4, 6 and 9. And that gives you 3, 4, 6, 9 quadruplet. What an excellent start this is. Because this quadruplet has given you the break-in. What break-in is that? As you can see, now what digit can you have here? Of course, a thermo line cannot have 1 in between, 9 in between, right? So 1 and 9 are eliminated. You cannot have a 2 as well because you cannot fulfill the thermo. You cannot have a 3 because 3, 4, 6, 9 quadruplet is there. 4 is not possible. 5 is not possible. 6 is not possible. 7 is possible. 8 is of course not possible because 9 would have to be here and then this cell gets stranded here. And of course 9 is not possible. So only digit remaining here in this cell would have to be 7. And after the 7, this is the lesser digit. So this would have to be 8 and this would have to be 9. What an excellent start of this Sudoku, guys. What an excellent start. So as you can see here, you already got a 3, 4, 6, 9 quadruplet here. And that gives you a 7 here. So the the remaining digits are 1, 2, 5 and 8. 1 cannot be in the midline, sorry, I always end up pressing the space here on F puzzles. So 1, 2, 5, 8, right? So 1 cannot be in the midline of a thermo. It would have to be 2 and 8, and 5 is also not possible, right? So 2 and 8, so here it would be 1, 2, 8, here it would be 1, 2, 8, and here it would be 1 and 2. So 1, 2, 5, 8 quadruplet here. Okay, so one more thing that I noticed after writing the 2, 8 is that if you have a 2 here, this would have to be 1, and if you have an 8 here, this would have to be 9. There is no other way. So if you have a 2 here, this would be the bulb, and if you have an 8 here, this would be the bulb, right? So that's an easy thing to notice, and with that I can write the pencil marks here. So this would have to be 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4. And of course 5 is not possible, so next would have to be 4 and 6. And with that, the next logic here I could see was this thermo now can have the thermo bulb. So for this thermo, we already got the thermo bulb, that the bulb had would have to be here, right? This would have to be the bulb end. I mean to say the bulb, the starting of the thermo. And for this line now, the starting of the thermo cannot be this. Now, why I directly deduced this was, so if this was the bulb, then the markings would have to be 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8 and 8, 9, right? So what happens here is that you get a 6, 4, okay, you directly get the digits here, but I'll just write without writing the digits here. What happens here is that 4, 6, Okay, 6, 7, 7, 8, 8, 9. Okay, so what happens here is that you get a 1-2 pair here, you get a 2-3 pair here, and that is the break in here, because what happens here is that both 2-3 pair will eliminate 2 from these 2 cells, both 1-2 pair will eliminate 2 from these 2 cells, and this clue now having the quadruplet of 1-2-7-8 will eliminate the possibility of 2 from these 4 cells. Excellent, right? And which means that this thermo will start from this end, this thermo will start from this end, and which means that this would have to be 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8, okay, 6, 7, 7, 8 and 8, 9, right? Nice, right? And with that I will just continue the Sudoku here. So which means that the yellow cells would have to have 3, 4, 2, 3, 4 and 6, no other possibilities, right? So we can directly mark those 2, 3, 4 and 6, 2, 3, 4 and 6, right? And red cells would have to have 6, 7, 8 and 9, right? So 6, 7, 8, 9 and 6, 7, 8, 9. That's nice. Which means that you cannot have an 8 here, you cannot have a 7 here. So that is a easy one to see. And which means that one would have to be in the green cells, right? So we can write that as well. One would have to be in the green cells. Now at this point of time, it really took me some time to notice the logic here. I was not sure if that was the intended solve path, but it was really, really difficult to see. So I directly eliminated that you cannot have a 6 here. Why was this the case? Because if you have a 6 here, the moment I write a 6 here, this would have to be a 4, this would have to be a 6. Easy, right? Because you have a 4-6 pair here. Okay, that eliminates 6 from here. That was easy. But if you have a 6 here, that directly gives you a 4 here, because some digit would have to be lesser than 6, and that was only 4 possibility. There was only one possibility, that was 4. And which means that you will have a 6 here. Now if you see here, box 8 cannot have 6 anywhere. A really, really sharp logic. And I am not sure if that was the intended solve path, but I really enjoyed this particular logic. And there were a few more logics that I enjoyed a lot. And with that, we directly get that this cell cannot be a 6, and this cell would have to be a 7, which gives you an 8 here, a 9 here. And that 8 eliminates 8 from this cell. That gives you an 8 in one of these 2 cells, right? Okay. And that eliminates 9 from this cell as well. And that eliminates 8 from this cell. So 8 would have to be in only one cell here, this cell. And that gives you 8 in one of these 3 cells. Okay, that's already marked here. And with that we'll continue this Sudoku. So at this point of time I really got stuck, and it was really difficult to see what next logic was. But after a while I deduced that this cannot be the end of the thermo, or maybe this cannot be the bulb of the thermo. Let us see what happens here. Okay, let me write all the possibilities. If this was the thermo end, so the thermo end will start from the higher digit, right? So 9 was not possible as the higher digit. Next possibility was 8. What happens if you have an 8 here? This would have to be a 7. I am taking the least number that is possible, the next number that is possible, and that will give us the contradiction if at all it is this would not fulfill the thermo end. So this would have to be a 6, right? You cannot have a 5 here, you cannot have a 4 and 6 as well, so you would have to have a 3 here, right? And that gives you 4 here, 2 here. Just a second. Okay, yeah, excellent. So that gives you a 4 here, a 2 here and a 1 here. You cannot have anything here. So after the 3, you can only have either 1 or 2, of course, right? And which means that if you have a 3 here, you will have a 4 year and 2 and 1 year, and both 1 and 2 are already here, right? So which means that 8 is not possible here. Of course 7, 6, 5 is not possible. 4, again that 4 gives you a 3 and 2 year, and you cannot have anything. Again same way, you cannot have a 6 year, because you cannot have a 5 year, that will give you a 4. Again 3, that gives you a 4 and a 2, and you cannot have here anything. Which means that this end cannot be the thermo end. Which means this would have to be the thermo end, this would have to be the bulb here. And with that we can write all the pencil marks here. This was really really difficult to see. And after quite a while I was able to notice that logic here. And with that we can eliminate 4, 5, 6 from here. So this would be 7, 8, so which means this would be 8 and 9. This cannot be a 5, this cannot be a 5, this cannot be a 5. This cannot be a 7 as well. Which means this cannot be a 6, which means this cannot be a 4. Right, these are the only possibilities on this thermo line here. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8 and 8, 9. Right, and okay. Okay, so the next logic here was, okay, so the next logic here was very very sharp here, very 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 difficult one. I directly eliminated that you cannot have a 1 year. So the moment you have a 1 year, you will have a 2 year and 2 year, right? Guys, just see this logic here. This was an excellent logic. So the moment you have a 1 year, you will have a 2 year and a 2 year. That will give you 3, 4, 6, 3, 4, 6. Now can you see what happens here? That's really sharp, right? So the moment you have a 1 year, that gives you 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 6. And both of these cells will have 6 now, right? So there is no way that you can place a 4 in these two cells. So the moment you have a 1 year, that gives you a contradiction here, and that directly eliminates 1 from this cell, right? And now we have come really close to finding the last breaking of this Sudoku, guys. A really really mind-blowing breaking. And the breaking was, if you have a 3 year, right? So it really took me a lot of time to solve this Sudoku at my leisure. But when I solved it, I was able to keep track of what I was doing, right? It was really really mind-blowing and really excellent solve path. And that solve path that really has kept it in my mind, and it was stored it forever. And the moment you have a 3 year, what happens here is that you will have a 2 year and you will have a 2 year. And this quadruple, which needs to have a 2 in one of these 4 cells, eliminates all the possibilities of 2 from these 4 cells, right? Excellent, right guys? Excellent. And this was the final break in here, which means that this cannot have a 3 year, this would have to have a 4. That gives you a 6 year, that gives you a 4 year, because this quadruple needs to have a 4 year. 4 cannot be here, 4 cannot be in any of these 2 cells, 4 would have to be here. Awesome, right? And which means that this would have to be 3, 2 and 1, right? And with that we get a 2 in one of these 2 cells, right? So a 2 cannot be in these 2 cells. So 2 would have to be in one of these 2 cells. 2 cannot be here in any of these 2 cells. So this would have to be 8. This would have to be 9. And 1, 2, 5, right? 2 cannot be there. 5 cannot be there. This would have to be 1. And you cannot have an 8 here. So you have a 2, 5 here and a 5 here. And which means that 9, 4, 6, 3, 2. 1, 5, 7, 8. 1 and 8 cannot be here. 5 also cannot be here because of the pointing. So 7 would have to be here. That gives you an 8 here. That gives you 5 and 1 here, right? 1 and 5. So 1 and 5 here. Okay. And with that, okay, so 1, 3 is possible here. Okay, so with that we'll continue this, and this would have to have a 2 here. By 1 and 7 are not possible, this would have to be a 2, and these two eliminates the possibility of 2, and you have 1 7 pair here. So 1 cannot be here, 1 cannot be here, and 1 would have to be here, right? And which means 2 would have to be here. That gives you a 1 here, that gives you a 5 here, a 1 here, a 2 here, a 5 here, a 3 here, and that really completes this Sudoku, guys. That is an excellent Sudoku here, and that really completes this Sudoku, because so you need to have 4 in one of these 3 cells. Is it necessary? No. So if you have a 4 here, so we can eliminate the possibility of 1 here. Can you have a 4 in these 2 cells? It is still possible, right? So 2 is not possible in these 2 cells. So 6 is not possible here, 8 is not possible here, and 7, 8, 9, right? So which means 6 also cannot be in these 3 cells. So 7, 9, so this would have to be 8, right? So 6 also is not possible in these 3 cells, right? So which means that 6 would have to be in, okay, 6 is still possible here. So 8 and 9, so this would have to be 7, this would have to be 9, this would have to be 8. And that gives you 8 in one of these 2 cells. So this would have to be 9, of course, after the 8, this would have to be 9. So that gives you an 8 here, that gives you an 8 here. That's nice. Okay, so 1 cannot be here. This would have to be 4, 5 and 6, this cannot be a 4. Okay, so that's a really excellent logic. You have a 1, 5 pair here, that eliminates 4 from this cell, right, because of the 4 here. So which means that 4 would have to be in the yellow cells. Awesome. Now 4 being in the yellow cells, you cannot have 4 in the green cells here, right? So for this quadruple, the 4 would have to be in one of these 2 cells, and there is only one way possible that you can have a 4 here, right? So yellow cells need to have a 4 because of this 4. You have a 1-5 pair, so 4 have to be in one of these 2 cells. That eliminates 4 from these 2 cells, and you have a 4 here, right? So the bulb starts from this this side, so this cannot be a 5, and this would have to be a 5. This would have to be a 3 because 1 and 2 are not possible, so eliminates 3 from these cells, and this would have to be a 3 and 5, 4 and 6, and 3 from these 3 cells gets eliminated, so this cell would have to be 3 here, and after the 4 you get 5, 6 or 7, 5 is not possible, so this cell would have to be 6 and 7, right? And 4 also is not possible here. So 3 is not possible here, 9 is not possible, so 4, 6, 5, so 6 and 4 are eliminated from this cell, so 3 and 9, and this cell would have to be 3, this cell would have to be 9, and that 3 gives you a 5 here and a 3 here. This 5 eliminates 5 from this cell, right? Okay, so 2, 6, 1 and 5, 1 cannot be here, 2 cannot be here, 6 and 5 would have to be here. 2, 6, 1 and 5, so 1 cannot be here as well, so 1 can only be in this cell, right? So this would have to be 2, 6 and 5. Okay, oh, 5 also cannot be here, so 2 and 6, so 5 cannot be here, 5 cannot be here, so this cell would have to be a 5. That gives you a 5 here, a 4 and 6 here, right? Seven would have to be here in this column, right? In this column, there is only one place for 7. So that gives you a 9 here, a 7 here. And this 9 does give us anything. So this would have to be 2, right? That was easy. After the 3, this would have to be 2, this would have to be 4, this would have to be 6. That gives you a 4 here, a 6 here and a 4 here. That's nice. It's getting completed now actually. And that gives you a 6 here. That gives you a 6 here. So these two digits are 7 and 3. So this is 3, this is 7, this is 1, this is 7, and that gives you a 1 to 7 and 1 to 9 and 3, right? 1 to 3, 9. So 2 and 9 here, 1 and 3 here, right? That gives you a 2 in one of these two cells. And a 5, a 2, 5, right? 2, 6 and 7, right? So 7 would have to be here. That gives you a 2 here, a 6 here, a 4 here, a 2 here, and a 6 here. That gives you a 6 here, a 4 here, a 5 here. That gives you a 4 here and a 6 here. That actually completes this Sudoku actually. So this 6 gives you this, okay, a 5 here, a 1, a 5 here, a 3 here and a 1 here. That gives you a 2, and these two digits are 3 and 9. So this would have to be 9 and this would have to be a 3. And with that we complete this gorgeous Sudoku, guys. What an excellent construction this was. I really enjoyed solving this Sudoku, and it was a really really excellent Sudoku. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I really thank Nityant Agarwal and Ilya Askar for giving me an opportunity to cover a video on this channel, and this was a brilliant construction. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Do like and comment if you want us to solve any other Sudoku variant or a puzzle genre, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.